Episode 1, A New Hop.
Crash, help me get this gizmo working. At long last, the world will have a way to recycle butter. Hey, that was a good one. Okay, hand me the transpalooper. That purple thingy.
Is this thing on? Yeah? Ha ha! I'm back, babies! Surrender to Cortex!
Mika, sucker!
Hey, genius, I can't actually hear you. I'm really far away, and I'm flying like a hovercraft or something.
I will deal with them. I have been fighting evil for many centuries.
What? You don't even got a body!
Help!
Crash! Help!
No.
I'm off to do bad things! Ta-ta!
I'm just gonna stay here a while.
Crash. Join game with Circle and shut the hell up with Akakwaku. Oh, I forgot you're on my back. This is awkward. Press Circle. Okay. What's up, Internet? This is Random Game Crap. Random Game Critic.
It's Super Yoshi.
And welcome to probably the stupidest idea I've ever had. Welcome to Crash of the Titans. This is the prequel to My Mutants, which we are playing out of order, but whatever. Crunch, what do you have to say? Oh yeah, you can't talk to people. Whoa! I forgot Circle. I've never played co-op with this game before. So Circle teleports you to the other person, which is nice for platforming, actually. Okay, I can hit Crunch, and he said, that's repugnified.
Ow, my legs! Cover your mouth when you sneeze. My legs! I'm gonna be a quadriparalegal! Now you're just making me mad!
Okay, that was fun and all, but let's move on. Anyways.
Yeah.
This game, it is different from, first of all, look on the top, that's the level up meter. It's hard to see because my cavalry card kind of sucks ass, but that's what, press square to smash stuff. Anyways, I keep, I don't know what to say. This game is very similar to Minor Mutant. It's a prequel to it. There's a few differences, though. First of all, you don't have unlimited lives. In fact, we have five. No, that's three. That's a three. We have three lives.
Can we hurt each other? Let's just check.
All right, sure. Yes, we can. That's not good.
That's not
good. Especially because we played at Bonkers again.
No, we're playing hard.
I know. It's so late. Wait, hand. Stop. They actually give conversations. It's not important, but it's kind of cool, though. What the hell? Let's just go kill him. Meet the rat missions. Oh yeah, you can only hit twice. Just boom, boom, and that's it. That's all you have. Wait, no. Triangle does that.
And a boom, boom, and then.
Yeah, no, that's it. Just attack twice, and that's it. You attack twice with square, and then you can attack the triangle also only once. The triangle is stronger. If you hold down triangle, you charge it up, and that breaks opponent's blocking. You cannot do the spin attack yet, but you can double jump. What else is there that you can do? Oh yeah, pressing square repeatedly glides.
Like a poorly animated glide.
Yeah, this. So this game is much. Okay, these are tips.
Come on, Crash. Jump with the X button.
But you see, I like to get all tips though because it matters though. So yeah, double jump up here, obviously.
Any bandicoots, so be quiet,
here we go. Vroom. Anyways, so you see the combos in the corner? Those actually count in this game. We'll get to what this is about in the end of the level. But yeah, this is not an open world game. There's actually levels. So as a result, we're actually gonna be doing like one level per video. Oh, I'm on your back. How the hell that happened?
Because I grabbed onto the thingy.
Okay, there we go. Okay, I'm very confused because I've never played this game in co-op before. I beat it myself on the highest difficulty setting, and it was actually hard. It was a fair challenge, though. Actually, no, it was a bit of an unfair challenge, but two people, it shouldn't be as bad, I don't think. Even if the other person is Nate.
What?
I just got a locked tip! Yeah, jump on a mushroom, and then... Oh, press X when you hit it. The timing's awkward, press X. There you go. Okay, now up here, this is a collectible. This is a, voodoo doll, which gives us concept art. I didn't hear what he said, gather up, but okay, whatever. Anyways, we're doing one level an episode. I'm gonna try and get all the voodoo dolls, because those are actually, like, hidden, and I know where most of them are, because they aren't hidden very well, in all honesty. I'm very confused. Anyways, I'm gonna go for all the voodoo dolls and all the mojo rooms, which I'll get to later. As for 100%ing the game, hell no. Absolutely not. Because, oh no! So there, we lost a life. We have 4 lives left now to finish this level. Or we go back to the beginning of the level.
Really?
Yes, really. This is a mojo multiplier, which we had in the last game. Doubles your mojo for a limited time.
Why did you come back with, like, no health?
Good question! This is a mojo room. Let's go in here once to show what it's like.
Why did I just take your health?
Collect 5,000 green mojo before the time runs out. Good luck!
Okay.
Minigame time! Let's do this! It'd be easier if you actually went... Okay. So, we have 30 seconds to collect 5,000 green mojo, which is... Wait, does the camera really lock in place if I go off the screen? What the hell?
Yeah, I can't move on.
Wow! So, the camera doesn't... Oh, my... This is the worst co-op system I've seen in a long time. That mojo does not count. Only green mojo counts.
Oh, really?
Yes, really. Oh, really? Yeah, really. Oh, really?
We're not gonna do it.
Crap. Come on. We don't want the... Oh, we did it. Okay.
We did it.
We did it! I'm not... Okay, I'm not gonna buy it. Okay, so here, we get another voodoo doll. Do you know what this voodoo doll unlocks? This voodoo doll unlocks the room we just played in.
Wow.
Literally, all it does is just gives you this room you can pick from the main menu, which is totally useless. But I'm gonna try and get all this anyway, because it's collectibles, per se, I guess. And I guess every time we warp, I'll make it put into my back. So, press circle to get out. Or maybe... Let me handle this, actually.
Oh, yeah.
You just flew for a minute. Okay. Whoa, what the... You're going! Go!
Oh my gosh. I knew I wasn't paying attention.
Why am I going now?
I'm not pressing anything.
I don't know! We can...
Does this switch every time
we jump? What? Jump again. I refuse to believe that's the way it... What is this? Hang on. I remember... Co-op. Okay, here we go. Leapfrog. Or piggyback.
What's piggyback? I'm scared.
Piggyback is normal.
Okay. I was gonna say...
Wait, press circle once. Okay. Now, jump once. Okay. We got this now. The default option is... Stupid. Ow! You made me teleport.
I'm just gonna go.
Fine. So this will be more challenging than the first game. And this is an open world, the levels are linear.
Oh my gosh, I almost didn't jump.
Yeah, you go from point A to point B, it's pretty simple. The game sucks at the moment because we have no attacks yet, but we actually do get more attacks as the game progresses. Because leveling up gives you more attacks in this game.
What?
Not just increases your stats. And there are not stats for mutants, which we'll get to later. You'll see, the combos in the corner actually do matter. As well as, on the right side there, 10 of 65. That's how many enemies you need to kill to get special awards, which I do not care about. I'll get into more of this at the end of the level. For now.
You can help.
Oh, I could, couldn't I? You know what? Keep playing for now. I'm really actually busy explaining stuff, because there's one more thing I want to talk about.
Okay.
It's a bit of a quality update, though. Like, before, in my older videos, if you look at any video older than this, you'll see that there is bars in the left and right sides of the screen. I fixed that now thanks to a program called Camtasia. So, real big thanks to Danmeister for showing me that Camtasia studio. So now the video fills up the whole screen. And not quite the whole screen, there's still a border on the edges. I could fix that by doing this. Like, I'm gonna do it right now here. This is literally a recording of a recording, which fits up the whole screen, but it drops the frame rate sometimes, so I'm not gonna do that. I'm gonna stick with it like this. Okay, quality updates, talking about the game. I believe we can actually get on with the LP now.
Yep. He didn't grab the ledge.
Yeah, this game is kind of... Let me back on.
How many lives do we have?
Three, what? Okay, so if we both die at the same time, then we lose a life.
Okay.
That this will be easy then. Actually, get on my back.
But you just said if we die at the same time, we lose life.
Wait, we just did die though. I don't understand. I know when I played it. Anyways, what's the thing that just appeared in the corner there?
It says I couldn't get out. It's a no circle.
I guess I'm... Okay, this is a spy bot. Which Ugook will now... Aku will now explain.
Was that a toilet?
Oops, sorry. No, it's not. It looks like it though, doesn't it?
Yeah.
So destroy all three spy bots to get a great reward. Which is... And we just learned the Norris Roundhouse. Press the like button to view the tutorial in case you don't know how to press square. So now we actually have a 3-hit combo. See? We actually have 3 hits now. But after 3 hits, he still trips like an idiot. Anyways, let's actually... You can't get any more out of that. Unless you have a mutant,
I was just testing out the Norris Roundhouse.
The Norris Roundhouse, indeed. Glide, sir!
I was gonna say double jumping is really awkward.
Alright, so... We got a new move, and actually a decent combo now.
Yep.
And as you can see, the combos in the corner, they go away immediately, unlike Mount Everest Mutant, where they keep staying like that until you get hit.
It says you can press square, but you can keep pressing jump over and over again.
Oh yeah, I remember something weird about that. X repeatedly or square repeatedly, either one works. The other spy bot was like a toilet, and vroom slopes. Aku Aku said that you get a reward for killing off these spy bots. It leads up to part of a reward. Again, it's kind of complicated. I'll explain at the end of this level. I started leaving the dark for a while. This is a long level also. The first level is a bit long. So I'm going to leave you in the dark for a while, but oh well. Wimps. Go kill him! Destroy the band, the rascal! You see weird things, like one time I heard a guy go, Hacksaws and noobs!
Oh yeah, ow. That guy just spawned and hit me right away before I can even react.
Yeah, Wumba Fruits are really nice in this game.
Oh yes, they are, because...
Yeah, because health matters, because again, you don't have infinite lives. Wait, or do... I don't know! I've never played co-op and I don't get it.
Where's me?
You are unimportant. You're unimportant.
My powers were useless against them. Behind these creatures.
I can't believe the Crash is voiced by Wacko from Animaniacs.
Yes, I know I don't have.
Kind of makes sense. Once you think about it.
True, we just missed a horrible joke though. And that is a spike.
We're scared of it, so let's go.
Yeah, remember in the old game you could do dance parties with the R1 button? Remember that? Yeah, quit rolling.
Tree!
Press and hold triangle to break enemies block, like I said before. Common enemies won't do that, but mutants will. Mutants will block you, and I'm kind of stuck down here. I'm floating. I'm not going to stop falling. Look at this. I'm actually falling, and I can't move. Okay.
You're stuck.
Circle it is. Can I press circle? Thank you very much. Okay. Now then. We're not here! You didn't convince me. You know, for kids!
Duh.
Meet Spike.
Hi, Spike.
Okay. So... Yeah, they're weak. Now press circle the jackets.
Yes.
And here we go. Now then, you press square to attack. Use it to break this stuff here, because only mutants can break these things. And don't punch me, that would hurt a lot. Oh no, press triangle to break those. Triangle is a strong attack. Holding it down does even more damage. And special attack is X, which uses up the purple blinking bar on top of the screen. Oh, get out of the way! Okay, never mind, it doesn't that... Now I have to wait for it to recharge. See, that's...
I thought that was jump.
No, you don't jump with mutants in this game.
And that's why I pressed it. I forgot about that.
Anyways.
Punch!
Anyways, this gate over here that has Ukuuka's face on it. This, you have to kill all the enemies to proceed through that. So this is literally just a gauntlet. And I just got a 1-up. I got a free jack. That's what it is. These things are fun because when you kick an enemy, they go flying off screen. Watch this. Boom! Or not.
Oh yeah, I've seen that. Yeah.
And that was another free jack. Those are always fun. And as the name suggests, free jack means you can jack a mutant in one hit. But on common enemies, it just kills them in one hit. Now then, alright, so...
I keep forgetting, I can't
jump. You cannot jump with the mutants, no.
I'm gonna...
We can move on now. Yeah, you're gonna do that a lot. And you can't store mutants either, so... Minor of Mutant did have some cool ideas. Yeah, Shaky Bridge. Minor of Mutant had some cool ideas, but honestly, I think this game is better, mostly because it's actually a challenge at times. Oh god, get stop it!
Wee. Okay.
And that's the last buy about. See what hidden those are? I want this spike now.
Oh, let's kill these guys.
Alright. I got my spike now, yay! Alright, now then. We're almost done with this level. I'm afraid to punch because I think I'm gonna hit you.
I heard him say hack, so...
Yeah. The Radnitions are what the game thinks is a nerd, which is nothing because I know what a nerd is, believe me.
Wait. Oh god! I want the silver one.
Well, you can get the silver one then.
Now
this is a bizarre mechanic over here, this giant blue ball. What you do is you have to go up to it and press circle to sacrifice your mutant, and that gives you what's inside of the container. I want to jack the mutant, not going to piggyback mode. That's gonna be a pain. Okay, now then. Again, if you have a mutant, go over here and press circle to sacrifice it. That gives you what's inside, which can be either a lot of mojo or sometimes even a one-up.
Okay, I'm getting comboed to death.
Yeah, that'll happen in this game a lot. I'm gonna warn you that right now. This game is hard.
Simultaneous jack.
Synchronized jack. Hooray. Well, remember, we also restore the health of your spikes also. And I like to just jack the other ones, so that doesn't take forever for them to die.
Oh my god.
Special move! Die, everybody. I just want to kill everybody in the world. I did not do that right at all.
I got a silver one.
Anyway, so how do you move on? Well, you know what? Forget these enemies. Let's just finish the level, shall we?
Sure.
Go over here and punch the tree. No, press triangle, I mean. So, really punch the tree. And there we go, Timber. And yeah, that's the end of the level.
Oh wow.
Now this is the end of load thing that I keep telling you guys about. Okay, so here we go. Bronze. Now here's the way this works. There are ranks in this level, which we are not going to be doing. Because, well, look at this. Mini Master means you must have killed at least 65 enemies, which is possible. In fact, we missed a lot of them, which is... it's easy. Mini Master's the easy part. Spy Bots are also pretty simple. Combo King can get pretty stupid later on, though. Meaning you must have hit that high of a combo at some point in the level. Getting all three will give you gold ranks, getting two will give you silver ranks, one is bronze, and zero is nothing. All they do is... the final reward is you get an extra skin for getting all gold trophies, which is completely useless, but it's a nice little thing, though. Anyways, we learned Norris Roundhouse in this episode, and that's it. And for clearing the level, we got the info on Radnition. This was the hidden voodoo doll we found in the level, and this was the mojo room we cleared. And this is for clearing the level also, and,
yeah.
Before we end the episode real quick, just let me explain one more thing real fast here. Alright, so this is the main menu screen. Episode 1 is the only episode we cleared so far, so this is Crash's stats. You can look at his health, spin time, slide time, upgrades, all this kind of stuff. And you can see there's a very limited amount of upgrades in this game. By the time we finish the game, we should have all of them, probably. Replay episode, no thank you. Replay Mojo Room 1, again, for clearing that green Mojo challenge, we unlocked this voodoo doll here, which lets us replay the Mojo Room. This was the hidden doll in the level. There's one of these in every level, I believe. This is just for clearing levels, and now, here's the stuff that we're not gonna do. Defeat 200 Radnitions, jack 50 spikes. Yeah.
Really?
Yes, really, those are the unlockables.
Jack 50 of them?
50 of them, yes. There's a nice way to grind with them, but... yeah, again, we're gonna complete these, just forget about these, because these give you skins, which don't even do anything. We'll probably unlock a skin eventually, and I can show you what it is then, but for now, you don't see in the lower right corner, there's a continue story button, which we're gonna be doing next time. Again, we're only gonna be doing like one level per video. Anyways, next time I Crash of the Titans, I'm not gonna be blabbing out so much about the game, and we'll actually be able to just get on with actually playing it.
Yay.
Which will actually be, yeah, I'm sorry this first episode was like so robotic and me just talking nonstop about the game and not trying to have any fun at all. Next time will be different, because next time we're actually going to be playing the game and... I don't know what to say. I'll just end the episode off now, alright? See you guys next time.
Bye.